Hi there, I'm Hasse Froberg, and I'm the singer and guitar player in the Flower Kings, and you're watching Live Prog.
Hello there, welcome to Live Prog. I am your host, Marcel Haster. As you can see, I am standing in a spot where I don't normally stand. That is because I have a premiere for you in this video review. I'm doing a vinyl review, and I'm standing here next to my record player, which for space reasons is tucked away in a corner a little bit. And I have a really beautiful release for you. The Flower Kings, Banks of Eden. Already you see the advantage of vinyl. I mean, look at this. You know, you really have a piece of artwork in your hands. Look at the track listing, you know? It's very easy to read. And if we open it up, really beautiful, like a painting. You know, this is something you want to hang on your wall in your house. Incidentally, I have a couple of albums in a nice spot where everybody can see them, you know, for decoration. Now, of course, it's not just decoration. It's good music. Now, one thing I noticed that it's really heavy. I mean, the album, the LPs, it's a double LP, 180 grams vinyl. If you feel the LP itself, it's really heavy. It's really solid, you know. Well, you can see it right here, spinning away. Everybody knows. I mean, we're not gonna have to spend a lot of time on that. The Flower Kings are back. They took a 5-year break to do other things, you know, to take a break from the Flower Kings because they've been going on for many years. They thought it was time to put their minds on something else, clear the Flower Kings out of it and, you know, refresh themselves. So they did their, separate things. Roine had Agents of Mercy, Jonas Reingold had Karmakanic, Hasse Froberg had Hasse Froberg and the Musical Companion, and Thomas Boden had his own solo work. But after 5 years, they got back together and released this beauty to the world. They have one new member on board, Felix Lehrman from Germany. He's behind the drums. Purely based on what I've heard on this album, I can say he's a very fine addition to the Flower Kings. You know, he really fits in very well. And the whole album sounds very organic, you know. Of course, the guys, the main guys, Roine, Jonas, Hasse and Tomas are playing together for many years, so they know what they can expect of each other. Despite the fact that this is very much labeled retro prog at its best, I find this a fresh sounding album. You can really hear that they were motivated again to bring the music to the world. Now, and what better way to announce your return than to open the album with an epic track. Numbers clocks 25 minutes and 20 seconds. Really amazing, and this is everything the Flower Kings stand for, you know. It's fantastic to hear that song, and it has a lot of variation. Everybody gets room, you know, the bass, the drums, the keyboards, especially the guitars, the vocals. I really love the fact that Roine and Hasse, you know, sometimes take the lead vocals but also do harmony vocals. I really love that very much. Well, you get plenty of it on this album. Now, there's an interesting thing. It's a double LP, and with the LP, I also got this in a nice plastic cover. Oh, and that's the CD. But there's a little difference, because if I look at the CD, it has 5 tracks. Of course, the epic numbers, For the Love of Gold, Pandemonium, For Those About to Drown, and Raising the Imperial. That is officially the Banks of Eden album. The second disc is something you only get when you buy the limited edition, has well, bonus tracks. Illuminati, Fire Ghosts, Going Up and Low Lines. Now, on CD, they're nicely separated from each other. But that's a little bit difficult on LP, because the first LP covers four songs. That leaves out one. Well, you can't fill another LP with just one song. So the four other tracks are also on the LP. And it's true, they are bonus tracks, because if you compare those tracks to the rest of the material, they have a different atmosphere, they have a different kind of sound. I mean, take Illuminati, for example. The first bonus track is a real slow starter and has beautiful guitar solo, very bluesy. And also the other songs are they're shorter, they're more compact, sometimes even a bit poppy. So they have a different feel to it, a different kind of atmosphere. Still, it is Flower Kings, and you can expect everything from them, because, well, Roine is a very creative guy. I mean, he writes a lot of music, he writes really fantastic music. In this case, not just Roine wrote the music, but also Thomas Bodin and Jonas Reingold contributed to the writing of the material. One thing I gotta show you, because we have, of course, the LPs, we have these beautiful covers with the lyrics. If we take it out, this is really beautiful. And it feels really heavy, so it is absolutely quality. I mean, kudos to InsideOut, you know, they didn't spare costs on the packaging of the LP. You know, it's all very solid, which is very important, of course, because, well, they have to last a long time. Now, this one is empty because the disc is spinning, but here you have some photos of the guys. And here's some little technical information. So, a really fantastic release. I'm very glad that the guys are back. I really enjoy listening to this album. The added bonus of the CD, and that is something you can't put on a record, is that there is a bonus interview film on it, so you can put it in your DVD player or in your computer and watch it with an interview of the band. So that is the extra you get on the CD. But I gotta be honest, I use the CD for the car, because I can't play this one, but when I'm here at home, I have good speakers, I have a very nice record player, I have a good sound system, and this one sounds fantastic on it. So I'm really happy that they are back, and they couldn't have released a better album to mark their return than Banks of Eden, because I've got a lot of Flower Kings albums. I haven't been really a fan until last year when I did a review of Tour Kaput, and really it clicked with me for some reason. And ever since, I really enjoy their music. But I gotta say, compared to the older material, in my opinion, this does sound really fresh, really fantastic, really inspired again. So I can't imagine you don't have it already, but if you do, and whether you buy the vinyl edition or the CD edition, it doesn't matter, as long as you buy the music to support the band. And, well, you're supporting your own ears as well, because they will love you for buying this music. If you go to the InsideOut store, they might even have different colors of vinyl for you, including orange and red. So, well, check it out, but if you don't mind, I'm going back to my record and enjoy the Flower Kings' Banks of Eden. And the truth